Hello friend, in today's lecture we are discussing aromaticity in annulenes. So firstly we are discussing here what are the annulenes. Annulenes are the conjugated hydrocarbons which are monocyclic and having even number of carbon atoms. Therefore we can simply say that annulenes are monocyclic conjugated hydrocarbons having even number of carbon atoms. So these all are the structures of annulene, in which we can say that all annulenes having even number of carbon atom, name of annulene is written in this way, in square bracket the number show us the carbon atom. So in this aniline there are 4 carbon atoms which are written in bracket, and after that here is writing aniline. So this is 4 aniline, this is 6 aniline, 8 aniline, this is 10 aniline, this is 12 aniline, 14 aniline, 16 aniline and 18 aniline. So in this type of aniline we have to study now the aromaticity. See here, in 4 aniline, so this 4 aniline is nothing but the cyclobutadiene. We can apply here the Haeckel rule. This is cyclic, this is planar, this is fully conjugated and containing 4 pi electron. Here are the 2 pi bond, therefore it has 4 pi electron, therefore this is anti-aromatic. So we can write here 4 aniline is anti-aromatic. In 6 aniline, 6 aniline is nothing but the benzene, and we have know that this is cyclic, planar, fully conjugated and contains 6 pi electron, because there are 1, 2, 3 pi bond and therefore it has 6 pi electron. So this is aromatic. This is 8 aniline. The name of this compound is cyclooctatetraene. That is, in short, it is known as COT, cot, cyclooctatetraene. See, this is cyclic, fully conjugated, but this compound is not planar. We are discussing why this compound is not planar. It is like as a tub shape due to the angle strain. Therefore, this compound is non-aromatic, cyclooctatetraene. Or 8 aniline is non-aromatic. This is 10 aniline. Here are the 10 carbon atom, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So therefore there are 10 carbon atom and hence it is known as 10 aniline. Friend, see in this compound, if we apply the Haeckel rule to this compound, then we can write this is cyclic compound, this is a conjugated compound. See, this is the double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond. So we can say that there are alternative single bond and double bond, therefore this is in conjugation. But what is about the planarity? See here, this type of hydrogen atom and this type of hydrogen atom is known as intra-annular hydrogen atom, and these intra-annular hydrogen atom are close together or close to each other. Therefore they produce here the steric hindrance, and therefore they can to go to apart from each other. Therefore this ring is not planar, this is non-planar ring, And due to this reason, we can say that this 10 aniline is non-aromatic. This steric hindrance due to the intra-annular hydrogen is known as a trans-annular interactions. So we can say that in 10 aniline there is trans-annular effect, and hence it is not planar compound, and due to the non-planarity it is non-aromatic compound. Friend, see here, if these hydrogens are replaced by the methylene group here, so this is the CH2 here, these two hydrogen are replaced by the methylene group here, we can write the name of this compound is, this is 1,6 methano, 1,6 methano, 10 aniline, 1,6 methano, 10 aniline. Now you can see here, these two hydrogen are not here, and therefore you can write there is no trans-annular effect, and hence this is aromatic compound. See, this is planar. Firstly, this is cyclic, planar, fully conjugated and containing 10 pi electron, and 10 pi electron is the aromatic system. Therefore, we can say that 1,6 methano 10 aniline is the aromatic compound. Instead of this CH2, we can replace here the X, and X is nothing but the sulfur, NH and oxygen. When you replace here the X is equal to sulfur, then this is known as the thioaniline. When we replace here the X is equal to NH, then we can say that this is azaniline. And when we replace here X is equal to oxygen, then we can say here this is the oxaniline. And we can see here there is no trans-annular effect, and hence you can write all these compounds are aromatic compounds. This is 10 aniline, and if we observe the planarity of this 10 aniline, here are the four inner annular hydrogen atom which are very close to each other, and due to this there is large transannular effect, and due to this transannular effect this is not planar compound, and we can say that this is non-aromatic compound. This is non-aromatic compound. Now in case of 14 aniline, this 14 aniline also having four inner hydrogen atom, and hence it shows the transannular effect, and due to this transannular effect it is not planar, and due to this it is non-aromatic. Now in case of 16 aniline, we can write here, see, here are the carbon number increases, therefore this inner cavity is greater, and due to this inner cavity these hydrogens are apart from each other, and therefore transannular effect is very less, and hence this is planar. Now according to the Haeckel rule, see, here are 16 carbon atom, and we know that the 16 carbon atom is in 16 carbon atom, or we can say that, see here, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, means here this is the 16 pi electron system, and if we measure here, so see here 2, then after 6, then after 10, and then after 14. But this system is include in anti-aromatic system. Therefore, we can say that though the system is cyclic, planar, conjugated and containing 16 pi electron, therefore this is anti-aromatic. And now in 18 aniline, this is 18 aniline, the inner cavity is very greater, therefore these 6 inner hydrogen atom are apart from each other, and due to this there is no transannular effect, and if there is no transannular effect, this is planar system. So this is cyclic, planar, fully conjugated and containing 18 electron, and 18 pi electron system is the aromatic system, so therefore this is aromatic system. So all these are about the aromaticity in anilines. Now we have to discuss next point, aromaticity in heterocyclic compound. In our syllabus there are 3 heterocyclic compounds are given. Aromaticity in heterocyclic compound. What are the heterocyclic compounds? The organic compounds which having hetero atom X is equal to nitrogen, oxygen or sulfur, these are the hetero atom. And if any organic compound contains one of these hetero atoms, then this compound is known as heterocyclic compound. In our syllabus there are given 3 heterocyclic compounds. See, this is pyrrole, this is furan, this is thiophene, these are the 5-membered heterocyclic compound, and in all these hetero atom there is a lone pair of electron which is conjugated to the remaining ring. See, this lone pair of electron and nitrogen is conjugated with this ring. See here, the lone pair of electron, single bond, double bond and single bond. In these 2 cases, furan or thiophene, this lone pair of electron is in conjugated with the ring. Therefore, if we apply the Haeckel rule to this compound, then we can say that these are the aromatic compounds here. These compounds are cyclic compound, these are the planar compounds, these are the fully conjugated compound and containing 6 pi electron. Why these compound containing 6 pi electrons? Here there are 2 pi bond and 1 lone pair of electron, therefore there are 6 pi electron, and therefore these compounds are aromatic compounds. Furan is also aromatic compound and thiophene is also aromatic compound. We can apply here the Haeckel rule. See, these are the planar compound, these are the cyclic compound, these are the conjugated compound and containing 6 pi electron. So all the criteria of Haeckel rule are fulfilled by this heterocyclic compound. Therefore, pyrrole, furan and thiophenes are aromatic compound. In examination, one question is asked here. The question is, aromatic properties of furan are less than the pyrrol and thiol. See here, if you understood the question, once again I repeat here the question. Furan is less aromatic than pyrrol and thiophen. That is, furan shows less aromatic characters than pyrrol and furan. Why? The reason is, if we study here the electronegative properties of nitrogen, oxygen and sulfur, then we can write here oxygen is more electronegative than nitrogen and nitrogen is more electronegative than sulfur. What is the electronegativity? It is the property of element to attract the electron towards itself. So, in this case, this oxygen is more electronegative than nitrogen and sulfur. Therefore, it cannot give this lone pair of electron to complete the aromaticity. So, it gives this lone pair of electron, but not gives easily this lone pair of electron due to its electronegativity. In case of nitrogen, the electronegativity of nitrogen is less than oxygen. Therefore, it gives this lone pair of electron to complete the aromaticity, and sulfur is less electronegative. It gives this lone pair of electron to the conjugation to complete the aromaticity very easily. Therefore, it is more aromatic. So, the answer is, answer of the question is depend on the aromatic, electronegativity of oxygen is more than the nitrogen and sulfur. Therefore, we can write here, thiophene is more aromatic than pyrrol and pyrrol is more aromatic than furan. So, we can write here the aromaticity order. Aromaticity order, thiophene is more aromatic than pyrrol and pyrrol is more aromatic than furan. Now, the last topic from aromaticity is the current concept or ring current concept of aromaticity. In examination, the question asked on current concept, that is short note, write short note on current concept of aromaticity. See here the new point. Current concept of aromaticity in earlier some lecture we are discussing the aromaticity on basis of Haeckel rule. All the compounds that we discuss in earlier lecture were studied by us depend on the Haeckel rule, but this is new concept of the aromaticity, current concept of aromaticity. This concept is related to the H1 NMR spectroscopy. See here, very simple example that we discuss here. Example of benzene. See, this is benzene According to Akel rule, we know that this is planar, this is cyclic, this is fully conjugated and containing 6 pi electron. Therefore, this is aromatic compound. But on the basis of current concept, we have to prove that this compound is aromatic. If any compound is exposed to the external magnetic field, see, this B0 is external magnetic field that we apply to this compound. See, there is a one rule. When any electrical particle or any charged particle exposed to the magnetic field, then there is formation of electricity. So, in this case, if this benzene is exposed to the external magnetic field B0, then see, this pi electron are conjugated. Therefore, this pi electron shift here, this pi electron shift here, this pi electron shift here, and again, this pi electron circulate through the ring. Therefore, we can say that there is formation of current. So, there is formation of current, and this current formation is nothing but the cloud of electron circulates through the ring. Cloud of electron circulates through the ring, and we can say that this is current. Now, when this current is formed in this ring, there is formation of magnetic field perpendicular this ring. Here we can say that if this ring is planar and this is the external magnetic field, if you apply here external magnetic field from this side and this is the ring, then the electron are circulate in this motion. The pi electron present in this ring are circulate in this motion, and there is formation of current, and due to this current there is formation of magnetic field by this compound, and this is called as induced magnetic field. But this induced magnetic field is the perpendicular to the plane of ring. This is plane of ring, and induced magnetic field is in this way, that is the in perpendicular direction. See, this is induced magnetic field. This is induced magnetic field. So we can write here the IM, induced magnetic field. Now we observe here these hydrogens present on the benzene ring. See here, these hydrogens are present in external part of the ring. Appears in H1 NMR in downfield, and the chemical shift value of these hydrogens are in between the 6.5 to 8.5 delta. But the hydrogen present in inner side of ring will be in shielded form due to this direction, or opposite to the direction of induced magnetic field, or opposite to the direction of applied magnetic field. Therefore, this hydrogen will give us the shielded value. If we compare this benzene to the cyclohexene, see here, this hydrogen of cyclohexene give us chemical shift value near about the 5.5 delta value, and this is 6.5 to 8.5 delta value. This is due to the ring current. In this case, if you apply external magnetic field to to this compound there is not formation of ring current because the pi electron are not in conjugation. Therefore, we can say that if any compound is aromatic, then there is formation of ring current, and due to this ring current there is formation of induced magnetic field, and somewhere this induced magnetic field is parallel to the applied magnetic field, and somewhere the direction of induced magnetic field is opposed to the applied magnetic field. So therefore the application of this ring current is in H1 NMR, and from the H1 NMR value we can say that this compound is aromatic or not. If any compound exposed to the in applied magnetic field and there is formation of ring current, then we can say that the compound will be the aromatic compound. So this is current concept of aromaticity. So friend, all these lectures, near about 5 lectures are on the aromaticity chapter, and I hope all of you understood all concept related to the aromaticity. The problem on aromaticity we'll discuss in the next lecture. Thank you.